أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Regarding major signs of the day of judgment from a hadith from Muslim. Muslim narrated that Hudhayfa ibn Asid al-Ghifari, may Allah be pleased with him, said Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came out to us when we were discussing. He said, what you are discussing? They said, we are talking about the hour. He said, it will never begin until you see 10 signs before it. He mentioned the smoke, the Dajjal, the beast, the rising of the sun from its place of setting, and descent of Isa ibn Maryam, Yajuj, Majuj, and three landslides, one in the east, one in the west, and one in the Arabian Peninsula, and the last of that is a fire which will emerge from the Yemen and drive the people to their place of gathering. Order of the signs of the day of judgment, there is no Sahih text which state that the order in which these signs will occur. Rather, the order of some of them is to be understood from the context of the test. According to my interpretation, Isa alayhi salam will come first, then Dajjal, because Iman will not be accepted when Isa alayhi salam, Iman will be accepted when Isa alayhi salam comes, but it will not be accepted when the Dajjal comes. Similarly, the events mentioned in the hadith of Isa alayhi salam life in second coming is not in sequence or in order, and not day-to-day life is mentioned. Some of the important events are mentioned, and Isa alayhi salam will not get miracles because he won't be a prophet in his second coming, because in the Quran it is there, the Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the last prophet. The Quran, ayat 40, Surah Ahzab, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not father of any of your men, but is the messenger of Allah and the seal of the prophets, and Allah has perfect knowledge of all things. And in my interpretation, Isa alayhi salam will not come from the sky with the same body, because in Quran it is there in Surah Anbiya, ayat 21, and we did not give them, the previous prophets, bodies that did not need to eat food, nor were they immortal. And that event mentioned in the hadith that he will descend on the minaret of Syria Masjid will not be his first event of second coming. If you examine carefully this hadith, this shows that the people already recognized him before this event occurs, and he may be descend from helicopter, and the people are waiting for him in the masjid. Therefore, the Imam of that time offered him to come to lead Salah. Otherwise, how can Imam knows the ghaib that the person came is the Isa alayhi salam?